Hello students, so in this video lecture we are going to see what is the bottom up evaluation of S attribute definition, then what is the L attribute definition, and what are the different translated schemes are present. Okay, so the S attribute definition is nothing but the syntax directed definition in which only the S synthesized attributes are present. Okay, such kind of a syntax directed definition we call it the S attribute definitions. Okay, so now we want to calculate the value of a synthesized attribute. To evaluate or to find out the value of a synthesized attribute, you are going to use the bottom up parser. So why we are going to use the bottom up parser? Because the synthesized attribute is depend on each child. Okay, so whenever we generated the parse tree, so the each node's value is totally depend on his child node. Okay, so we are defining here how to evaluate the synthesized attribute using the parser. Suppose we are giving this particular example, and in this example, so the value of A is totally depend on the X, Y, and Z. Okay, so this is my, and what is my semantic action here? So the A dot A, this small A is nothing but the synthesized attribute of a grammar A. So small X is nothing but the synthesized attribute of X. Small Y is nothing but the synthesized attribute of Y. And Z is nothing but the synthesized attribute of this capital Z. And so the this particular value of a dot a is nothing but the function of x, y, and z. Okay, so whenever I want to find out the value of this small a, I require to know the what is the value of this small x, small y, and small z. On this value, we apply such kind of a function. So function is nothing but there is an addition, multiplication, division, subtraction, any kind of function is present there, and by that function I am calculating this particular value. So how I am evaluated actually that using the stack. So actually there are present two kinds of a stack. One is nothing but my parse stack, and another is nothing but value stack. So on a parse stack, we are actually sending the grammar symbol, and the value stack, then I am sending the actual the lexem value, okay, or lexical value. So here the x dot x will be firstly stored, then y dot y, and then z dot z. So the z dot z is nothing but the my top of the stack, and x dot x is nothing but currently in a bottom upper stack. So okay, it will be generated like, so this is nothing but my the grammar symbol and its corresponding synthesized attribute, and this my top of the stack or stack will be looks like this is top, this is top minus one, this is top minus two, and whenever I encounter x, y, z, this particular handle I'll be directly replacing by the a. So whenever I'm replacing by a, at the same time I'm going to calculate the value of a dot a. So how I'm going to calculate that value? So the value will be calculated on the basis of this function, and that value of this a dot a will be stored into the top of the stack. So it will be stored into the top of the stack in this way. Okay, so top of the stack is grammar symbol is nothing but a, and the value is nothing but a dot a. How I'm going to find out this? So this x, y, z is replacing by the a, and actual the function will calculate this particular a dot a value from this x dot x, y dot y, and z dot z. Okay, so I'll be given one example here, and by that example I'm going to show you how to describing the evaluation of a attribute definition using the bottom up parser. Okay, so this is my production and this is my semantic rule. Okay, so you have a production for grammatical symbols, you require to describing the semantic rules yourself. Okay, so what is my semantic rule? Whenever you encounter digit, that value will be assigning to the f. Okay, so means that value will be assigning to the top of the stack. Okay, so currently my parse stack will be present f, and digit will be nothing but that value. Then this particular f will be assigning to the t now. So f will be replacing by the t. So my top of the stack will be the t, and the values of a t is nothing but the digit. Okay, like this we are going to perform it. Now, so for that purpose we are going to, so this is my simple calculator. So this is my simple example I am going to use, parse tree I am going to use. This parse tree I am going to generate for this particular input 3 into 5. So 3 into 5 you derive by t, t into f. So how I am going to derive this by bottom up parser? 3 is reduced to the f is reduced to the t, 5 is reduced to the f, t into f is reduced to the t, and t will be reduced to the e. Okay, f will be reduced to the t, digit will be reduced to the f will be reduced to the t, and then digit will be reduced to the f, then t star f will be reduced to the t, then t reduced to the e, and e reduced to the l, and directly I'm printing up the value. Okay, like this. So this t and this t1 both are same. Only difference is this t1 will be denoted. This is the right hand side variable. This is the left hand side variable. Now, where will be my, so this my reading pointer will be here in a tree. Okay, so whenever I encounter the tree, I'll be storing that tree into the top of the stack. Okay, and the value is also three. Value is also three. Now I encounter the digit. So now digit I'll be going to reduce to the f. So I'll be reduce tree to the f. Okay. So now what is my semantic action? There is no any semantic action. So my value will be as it is. So I'm keeping the value as it is. Now there is a now I'm going to. So this f will be now reduce to the t. Okay. Here now f will be reduce to the t. So now f will be reduce to the t. Because we encounter the handle here, so handle will be replaced by the corresponding right hand side. And what is my semantic rule? There is no any semantic rule, so I'm keeping as it is the value. So I'm keeping the as it is the value now. So t I'm not going to replace directly by the e. Before that I'm going to push the star into the top of the stack. So I'll be pushing the star into the top of the stack. So it will be like this. So top minus one is nothing but my t, and then top is nothing but my star. Okay, then t star. So there is no any such kind of right hand side production is present. So because of that I'm not going to replace by the left hand side variable. Now the value will be as it is. So it will be a t star, and there is a 3 and star. Okay, now I'll be inputting the 5 into the top of the stack. So I'll be inputting the 5, and it will be, so it will be the t, then star, and then 5. Okay, and here 3 star, and then 5. Then 5 will be replacing by the f. 5 will be replacing by the f. So it will be the t star and f vertically. So I'm defining like, so it will be look like this t. Okay, then here it is nothing but my star, and then there is a f. Okay. And what will be the my value stack 3, then I'm defining here star, and here it is nothing but my, the current value is nothing but 5. So I'll be replacing like a 5. Now I'll be replacing this f again, reducing to the, no, now I'm not going to replacing the f by t, but I'm replacing the t star f. So now I encounter t star f. So t star is f is reduced by the t. So whenever I'm reduces the t star f by a t, at the same time I'm performing the operation. So what is my semantic rule? Value top minus 2. So what is the value top minus 2? 3 into value of a top. What is the top? 5. 5 into 3 is nothing but 15. So value of a top is nothing but 15. So I'll be input it like. Okay. Now I encounter the t. So t, that t will be replacing by the e. So whenever I'm replacing, so t will be replacing by the e, and the value of a top of the stack in a value stack will be the 15 as it is. Now e will be replacing by the l. E will be replacing by the l. So I'll be replacing e by l. So whenever I'm replacing e by l, at that time I'm calling the printf value of a top, and then I'm displaying the value. Okay. So such kind of a bottom up relation will be used for the s attribute definition. Okay. Now we are moving for the, so this is made by the translator. Now we are moving for the L attribute. So what is the L attribute definition? Already we describing that the context programmer is not only used for the parsing purpose, or not only used for the syntax analysis purpose. It also going to use for the find out whether it is whether that particular input string is meaningfully correct or not. For that purpose, for calculated that meaning or to find out the meaning, we are assigning some attribute to the each grammar. Okay, so there are two kinds of attributes are present. One is a synthesized attribute, and another is nothing but the that inherited attributed. Okay, so the value of a synthesized attribute is depend on the child node. Okay, so whenever I'm combining the context free grammar and the attribute, then such kind of a definition we call it as a syntax directed definition. And when we call the syntax directed definition as a L attribute definition, if that syntax directed definition present the inherited attribute. Okay, so that we defining inherited attribute. So syntax directed definition is a L attribute if each inherited attribute of xj on the right hand side depends only on, so right hand side value, right hand side here. So here after xj minus 1, xj plus 1, xj 2 plus 2, it is totally depend on the left hand side variable or based on its parent node. What is the parent node? That is nothing but e. Okay, so such kind of a attribute we call it the inherited attribute. So here we define it. So whenever I want to calculate the value of a attribute value of a x, so x is nothing but suppose my grammar symbol, y is the grammar symbol, z is the grammar symbol, and here small x is nothing but attribute of x, small y is the attribute of y, small value of attribute of z. Now I want to calculate the value of x dot x. So that value will depend on the is attribute, y value depend on the is attribute, and z value depend on the it attribute. That we see here the attributes of this child totally depend on its parents. Such kind of attribute we call as inherited attribute. Okay. So y is also depend on a, z is also depend on a, also a, and all the right hand side variables attribute depend on the left hand side. Okay, so the z is depend, so that is we call as l attribute. So z is depend on the x, then also z is also depend on the y, also that we call as the inherited attribute. But if the value of x is depend on the value of z, if the value of attribute of x depend on the value of attribute of z, such kind of attribute we are not called as a L attribute. L attribute definition, such kind of grammar we call it is not a L attribute definition. Okay, so we are defining here example. Okay, so a derive lm, a derive qr. So this l dot I, so I is nothing but inherited attribute of L. Okay, A dot I, so the I is nothing but inherited attribute of A. L dot S, so there are present more than one attribute also. One is the inherited, another is a synthesized attribute. So L also have the inherited attribute also and synthesized attribute also. Here also there are some inherited attribute and some inherited attribute. Okay, synthesized and inherited attribute. So we want to check whether this particular productions are correct or not. Semantic rule, L dot I is equal to A dot I. So I M is nothing but the function. So it is actually a function like a unary minus, or the we are defining here as a, we are describing as a root, any kind. Okay, so L dot I, so the value of a inherited attribute of L is depend on this parent, so we call this is a correct semantic. M dot I, they depend on the L, that is also correct, because this is the right hand side variable attribute depend on the left hand side variable. Okay, attribute. A dot S is equal to M dot S. A dot S is M dot S. A dot S is nothing but synthesis attribute depend on the child, that is also accepted. A R dot I depend on the A dot I. Okay, that is also correct, because the child is depend on its parent. Q dot S, A dot S is depend on the Q dot S, that is also accepted, because synthesized attribute value is depend on its child attribute. Okay, Q dot I is equal to R dot S, means R dot Q dot I left hand side attribute value depend on the right hand side attribute, that is not acceptable, because of that we say it is not a L attribute definition. Okay, so above syntax definition is not L attribute, because the inherited attribute Q dot I of the grammar symbol Q depends on the attribute R dot S of the grammar symbol to its right. So A derives QR, we call it is not L attributed, but A derives LM, we call it is a L attributed definition. Okay, now we are moving for the translation scheme. Till now, what are we defining? So we are writing the syntax-directed translation, in which we are writing a context-free grammar, and in a right-hand side, we are writing the semantic action. Okay, so in a translation scheme, this is possible that in a context-free grammar production itself, in that production, we are writing the semantic action. Okay, which is enclosed between the opening and closing curly braces. Okay, that is also acceptable. Okay, attributes are used to evaluate the expression along the process of parsing. Okay, so how I'm going to performing the parsing, or how I'm going to evaluate it, as we are going to starting from the top to bottom and left to right. Okay, as we are going to reach to that particular node, and if that node present any semantic action, we directly evaluated or we directly executed that semantic action that we defining here. Okay, so what we defining here, that we describing in the help of example. Okay, so we want to convert it into infix to postfix notation. So this is my grammar, and in that grammar I'm directly writing. So till now, what we writing is syntax directed definition, firstly writing a production, and that after completion of a production, we're writing a semantic action. But here, in a production itself, we are writing the semantic action. तो व्हाट इज माय प्रोडक्शन आर डिराइव एड ऑपरेटर, जो भी आपका ऑपरेटर होगा वो डिस्प्ले करो यहाँ पे टी, देन माय सिमेंटिक एक्शन, देन माय ग्रामर सिंबल और नल. ओके हियर टी डिराइव्स नम, उसके बाद प्रिंट नम. सो व्हेनेवर आई एम राइटिंग अ टी, मैंने अगर टॉप डाउन पार्सर यूज किया तो टी के दो नोड हो गए, एक तो नम होगा, दूसरा होगा प्रिंट नम डॉट वैल्यू. इसके आर के कितने होंगे, एड ऑपरेटर वन, टी इज सेकंड, दिस सिमेंटिक एक्शन विल बी द थर्ड, आर वन विल बी फोर. ओके सो लाइक दिस. Now we are defining that by the example. So for the translation scheme, we are going to use the top down parser. And how I'm going to evaluate that, or how I'm going to solve the attribute. So for that purpose, I'm going to use the depth first search. That is top to bound, top to bottom, left to right. Okay. So now I want to generate this. So how I'm going to generate A derives TR. Then T will be derives num. So num, t derives num and print value. So what is my first number? That is 9. And then print num dot value. So what is the value? 9. So I'll be display the 9. So now r. So 9 ke baad kya hai? Minus 5. So I am writing add operator. So it will be generated. Operator is nothing but minus t, and then print add operator dot lexem. So what is the lexem associated with this particular number minus? So I am writing here print that particular minus. Okay. और उसके बाद आई एम राइटिंग द आर वन. नाउ टी इज माय वेरिएबल, वेरिएबल विल बी रिप्लेस्ड बाय द करस्पोंडिंग प्रोडक्शन. सो टी डिराइव्स नम, सो व्हाट इज माय नंबर एसोसिएटेड विद दिस माइनस, दैट इज नथिंग बट 5, एंड आई एम राइटिंग 5 प्रिंट दैट नम वैल्यू. सो आई एम राइटिंग नाउ आर अगेन विल बी रिड्यूसिंग बिकॉज आई वॉन्ट टू डिस्प्ले द प्लस 2, सो आई एम राइटिंग हियर प्लस. सो द एड ऑपरेटर टी प्लस, दैट इज नथिंग बट माई दिस ऑपरेशन प्लस, देन टी, देन प्रिंट add operator dot lexem. So what is the operator associated with that lexem? That is nothing but plus. So I'm printing the plus and then finally r1. So that t is again divided like a num print value. So I'm displaying here num print value. Okay. So what is the value? Number 5, and that value number is nothing but 2. That value I want to print here. So I'm writing the 2. So r I'm replacing by the num because I'm writing 9 minus 5 plus 2, and then I'm going to display. So how I'm going to check that whether it is executed or evaluated or converted into the postfix notation. So for that purpose, I'm performing the def first, first traverser. Okay. So I'll be starting from here. So first I'm going to top to bottom print 9. So I'm display here 9. Okay. Then I'll be going here. Then I'm describing like this here. Then it will be comes here. Then I encounter print 5. Okay. So I'll be display the 5. Okay, now I'll be moving from here. I'll be visited this node. So what is the action here? Minus 2. So I'll be display the minus. Then I'll be defining like here. So I'll be move here, then here. Then I'll performing here print 2. So I'll be display the print 2. And then I'll be defining print plus. So I'll be display the print plus here. So I'll be executed like this print plus. And then I'll be going to stop because I'll be direct reduced to the in. Okay, so by this way, actually, I'm going to also evaluating that particular expression source. Okay, so that is nothing but my translation. Okay,